Ella tiene apagado el otro lado, ¿no?
Living, living soul.
Good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening. Hello.
Good evening.
Good evening, Susana. How are you?
Fine. Sorry.
Oh, now tired. I can hear you. Oh, tired. Yes, I bet. Okay, how was your day?
I went to San Salvador.
Okay. All right. So you had to travel a bit. That's tied in. Okay. Jose Manuel, good evening.
Good evening. How are you?
I'm fine, and you?
I'm fine.
Great. How was your day?
Tiring day.
You had a tiring day. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. You had a lot of work, I bet. You had a lot of work.
Oh, yes. Difficult day.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that's so sad. But it's almost done. That's the good news.
I'm happy for the class.
Oh, excellent. I'm glad to hear that. Hello, Frank.
Good evening, teacher. Good evening, everybody.
How's everything? How are you?
I'm very, very fine. I had several things to do for this day.
Okay.
Nice. And how about you, teacher?
Well, I'm kind of tired today, but I'm good. I'm fine. Yes, ready for the class and for, you know, finishing with all my work for today. Because yeah, okay, it's been so crazy. Many things to do. I mean.
Very well, maybe.
Yeah. Okay, Carlos. Good evening.
Good evening, Miss.
How are you?
I feel tired. I need to go to bed.
Oh, yeah. So do we, right? We all want to go to bed, but let's go over the class and then we go to bed. So how was your day?
Fine.
That's good. All right. I'm glad to hear that. Maria Carmelina, good evening.
Good evening, teacher.
How are you?
Good.
Great. How was your day?
Good day.
You had a good day? Okay.
Yes.
Excellent. I'm happy to hear that. Very good. And Zulma, good evening, Zulma.
Good evening, teacher.
How are you?
Fine.
Okay, great. How was your day?
Very good.
It was a good one? Nice. I'm glad to hear that. And how about you, Dalia Rodriguez?
Hi, good evening. Well, I have a long day, but I'm glad to be here.
Oh, okay. So yeah. Was it fine at the end or?
I think it's fine. Okay. I survived.
All right, you made it through.
Yeah, I made it through. I hope tomorrow too.
Okay, hopefully. We're almost done with the week, so that's good news. We're almost on Friday, so. Yeah, that's a little, what to say. That's a piece of good news, right? Right? You feel different when it's Thursday, almost Friday. And then, well, sometimes we still have to work on weekends, but
for me, kind of every Monday is, every day is Monday for me.
Oh, no. Pretty bad.
Yeah.
Okay. Cecilia Emperatriz, good evening.
Good evening, Miss.
How are you?
Fine, fine.
Great, how was your day?
With a lot of work, really of course, and heavy traffic.
Oh no, that's pretty bad.
Yes.
Okay. And how about the homework with your kids? Did you have to do some work with them? You do it every day, I guess.
Yeah, every day.
Oh, okay. All right. Let me see, Alfonso Antonio. How are you?
I'm fine, Miss. Good evening.
Great. How was your day?
It's very good.
Okay. So tell me about it. Did you have to work?
My world is very nice.
Okay, great. I'm glad to hear that you had a good day. Then Abel Hernandez, good evening.
Good evening. How are you?
I'm fine. And you?
I'm tired.
You're tired. Okay. Yeah. I bet you had a hard day too. You had to work.
Very, very, very hard.
Oh no.
Thursday and Friday, very hard.
Oh, okay. Those days are harder for you.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. The good thing is that we're almost done with Thursday, right? And then Arnoldo, good evening.
Good evening. Good. Thank God. Hi, how are you?
Oh, okay. Nice. So, how was your day?
good.
It was all right. Excellent.
Right.
Rafael Alexander, good evening.
Hey, good evening.
How are you?
So-so.
So-so? Really? How was your day?
Yes.
How was your day?
No entiendo.
Oh, okay. ¿Qué tal su día? How was your day?
Ah. So.
Just okay. Was it okay? Rafael, was it okay? Yeah. All right, Dalia Ramos, good evening.
Hello, teacher, good evening.
How are you?
Fine.
Great, I'm glad to hear that. How was your day?
A day, a crazy day.
Oh, you had a crazy one too? What happened?
The work is very, very ¿cómo se dice cansado?
Hiding.
Hiding. A day hiding.
Oh, okay. Right. So let's go over the English class so we can get to something different from work, right? Now let's forget about work, let's work on this, and let's practice, let's keep on practicing English. So welcome everybody to our fourth class. And we're starting with a review of the alphabet, right? That we had been practicing. So let's practice it one more time. Repeat after me, A. Okay, good. Now let me ask some people to read some letters. So let me change the color of some of the letters and I'm asking some of you to read them. For example, let me just highlight them in that way. Arnoldo, can you read those?
Hey.
Continue.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. So B. you read. Mm-hmm.
C, D.
Great. Okay, now let's see Zulma Gonzalez.
O, P, Q, R.
Very good. Cecilia, you're next.
T, U, B, W.
Great. Carlos.
L, M, N, O.
Very good. Jose Manuel.
D, E, F, H.
G.
Ah, G. Good.
One more time.
D.
Say it again.
E, F, G.
Very good. Abel Hernandez. Now you go with this.
W, X, Y, V.
Great. Susana Margarita.
C, D, E, F.
Perfect. And Dalia Margarita. Check your microphone, please.
Sorry. H, I, J, K.
Thank you. Very good. Carmelina.
T, B, oh, okay, perdón. O, B, Q, R.
Very good. Rafael.
B, W, X, Y.
Excellent. Alfonso, Alfonso Antonio.
Yes. C-E-F.
Very good. Dalia Ramos.
R-S-P-U.
Great. Okay, let's keep on practicing the ones that we have a little trouble with. Remember that this one is letter C. C. Please.
C.
C.
C. Okay. Then we have this one, which is S.
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 S. C. S.
C.
S.
And this one is Z. Z.
Z.
Z.
Okay. Let's practice them one more time. C.
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 S,
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 Z.
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 Say them all. C, S, Z.
Z,
S, Z.
One more time. C, S, Z.
C,
S,
Z.
Okay, good. Now, let me tell you about this ones. Remember, this one is B, B, and B, this one,
B,
V, V,
B.
Okay, B. Repeat after me. B,
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 V,
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 B,
B,
B.
And now let's see this. J.
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 G.
G. Okay.
G.
Repeat. G.
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 J.
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 G.
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 J.
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 J. Okay. Now, how about the vowels? We got I.
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 A.
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 I.
I.
Okay, also here we have letter E.
E.
Okay, so we have A, E,
A,
A,
E,
I.
This one is?
A.
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 This one?
I.
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 E.
E. And this one?
Oh.
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 And then we have?
U.
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 U. Okay, so repeat please. A.
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 E.
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 I.
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 O.
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 U.
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 Okay, and do you have any questions about any of the letters in the alphabet? No, we're clear. Okay, so how about we practice spelling a couple of words? Let me see, and let me get the words from you. So let's see, Susana, you tell Frank a word and then Frank spells it. Susana, can you tell me a word in English?
Teacher alfabeto?
It could be any word, just whatever word that comes to your mind. A word in English. Una palabra en inglés.
Oh. Drink.
Drink.
¿Cómo, okay. compañera?
Drink.
Drink. Drink. D R I N K.
Very good, Frank. Now, Frank, you give a word to Arnoldo.
Arnoldo, la palabra es heaven.
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 Heaven. H E I
B E. One more time, Arnoldo. One more time, please. Repeat it.
H E I B E.
N. Heaven. H E A.
N.
A V E N.
Yes,
right? But... Heaven. Okay.
Heaven.
Very good, Arnoldo. Okay. Now give a word to Abel. Abel Hernandez.
Vamos a home.
Okay, so Arnoldo has to give a word to Abel. Home. Okay, Abel, spell it.
Home, home. H. U. O. N. E.
E. Okay, home.
Right, sorry, I couldn't really hear that, so sorry. So, Abel, did you spell home?
Home. H-O-M-E.
Very good, thanks, Abel. Now, give a word to Jose Manuel, please. Abel, you give a word to Jose Manuel.
Okay. Buddy.
Body.
Body.
Body. B A D Y.
Okay, it goes with O, body. One more time, Jose Manuel.
And the tomorrow.
Oh, okay, that's the word. Tomorrow, it's for, let's say, Carmelina.
T-O-A-O-R-R-O-W.
Very good, Carmelina. Now give a word to Carlos, please.
Family.
Honey.
Family.
Family.
Come on.
Family.
Family. A M I L Y.
Okay, very good, Carlos. All right, so we're going to stop with the spelling over here. Let's continue with our next activity. So here I have a reading. We are going to listen to it first. I'm going to read it for you. And then we are going to get the chance to practice it. So listen to me, please. Can you turn off your microphones, please, everybody? Thank you. Thank you, everybody, for turning off your microphones. Okay, there we go. So it goes like, hello, my name is Jack, and this is my family. I have a sister. Her name is Sarah. I have two brothers. Their names are Gabe and Ryan. My parents are called Ted and Sandra. We live together in our big house. It's very nice. Also, I have four grandparents. My dad's dad is called George, and he's married with Granny Lucy. My mom's parents are Philip and Susan. I love my grandparents. So it's very short and very simple, right? Now, let me ask for some volunteers to read it. Do we have any volunteers? Tengo voluntarios para leerlo. Frank. Yes? Okay, go ahead.
Yeah, entonces.
Please.
Hello, my name is Jack. This is my family. I have a sister, her name is Sarah. I have two brothers, their names are Gabe and Ryan. My parents are called Ted and Sandra. We live together in a big house. It's very nice. Also, I have four grandparents. My dad's dad is called George, and he's married with Granny Lucy. My mom's parents are Philip and Susan. I love my grandparents.
Thanks for reading, Frank. Okay, let me get a second volunteer to read. Anybody else?
Hi, Tony.
Okay, Tony, go ahead.
Hello, my name is Jack, and this is my family. I have a sister. Her name is Sarah. I have two brothers. Their names are Gabe and Ryan. My parents are Colin, Ted, and Sandra. We live together in our big house. It's very nice. Also, I have four grandparents. My dad is called George, and he's married with Granny Lucy. My mom's parents are Philip and Susan. I love my grandparents.
Okay, thank you for reading, Tony.
Presente,
Abel, go ahead and read.
Okay. Thank you. Hello, my name is Jack, and this is my family. I have a sister, her name is Sarah. I have two brothers, their names are Gabe and Ryan. My parents are Colette, Ted, and Sandra. We live together in our big house. It's very nice. Also, I have four grandparents. My dad died. He's called George and he's married with Granny Lucy. My mom's parents are Phillips and Susan. I love my grandparents.
Okay, very well. Thanks, Abel. Now repeat after me. Name.
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 Family.
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 Sister.
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 Brothers.
Brother.
Brothers.
Brothers.
Parents.
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 Cold.
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 Cold. Cold.
Live.
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 Live. Live.
Together.
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 House.
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 Very.
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 Grandparents.
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 Dads.
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 Dads. Dad.
Dads.
Dads.
Dad.
Dad.
His.
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 Married.
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 Granny.
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 Moms.
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 Moms. Parents.
Moms.
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 Parents. Parents.
Okay. Do we have any questions about the vocabulary in the reading? Questions? No questions? Okay. All right.
Pregunta.
Tell me.
Como no lo puedo decir por mí. Este, entonces, cold es igual a se pronuncia igual a frío. Cold.
Cold. Uh-huh. Sí, sería la misma pronunciación. Cold. Uh-huh. Okay. Es igual. Okay. Okay.
Gracias. Thank
you. You're welcome. Any other questions? Do we understand the meaning of granny?
Granny.
Yes. Abuela.
Yes.
What is?
It's
what
another is word for grandmother. It's like grandmother. You can also say grandma, granny. Okay.
What is granny in Spanish?
It would be like what a way to call your grandma, like abue, for example. Abue, like. Like how okay. You call your abuela, right? Your grandmother. Okay, then let me tell you, our next topic is possessive adjectives. So here in the text, we can find some different ones. The first one is my, right? My name. What other possessive adjectives can we find? Check the reading and tell me what are the possessive adjectives that we see in the text.
My family.
My family. Okay. Good.
Any her other? Name.
Her name.
Her name.
Yes.
I have.
I have. No, that is not a possessive adjective?
No.
No, but we have more. Let's look for the others.
Her.
Their
names. Their names. What else?
My
parents.
Parent.
My parents. My parents. Okay.
Our big house.
Our big house.
Our big house.
Any other?
My dad's dad.
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 My dad's dad. That's another kind of possessive. Very good. What else?
My mom's.
My mom.
My mom's parents. My mom's parents. Okay, so as you see, we have some different forms for the possessive adjectives. Hi, do
sorry, teacher.
Go ahead.
Lo voy a preguntar en español, perdón.
It's okay.
¿Por qué I have no es posesivo?
En el caso de I have, tenemos la estructura de una oración. No es realmente una frase posesiva como nosotros. Por ejemplo, cuando digo my name, mi nombre, ¿verdad? Estoy hablando de que el nombre pues me pertenece en cierto modo. Y cuando digo I have, estoy diciendo que yo tengo. Entonces, ya estamos hablando de una acción, por así decirlo. Estamos utilizando un verbo.
Okay, okay. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. You're welcome. Okay, so as you see, we have some different forms for the possessive adjectives, right? We got my, their, here, and our, for example. Then we also have this kind of possessive, which is using the apostrophe S, like in dads and moms. So that is what we are going to study next. Let's continue. Possessive adjectives. We use the possessive adjectives to express possession. Así como el nombre lo indica, es para expresar posesión or belonging, right? That I have something, that something is mine, yours, or whoever owner it has. Then here we have some examples on how to use the possessive adjectives. I have, this is my sister. Can you help me to read the next one, Dalia Ramos? Read.
Spell.
Read. Leer, por favor.
Ah, perdón. His pillow is.
His pillow.
Pillow is. His pillow is soft.
Okay. Good. Thanks. So you see his pillow.
His next pillow.
Thank you, Dalia. Next one, Carlos, help me to read it, please.
This is her phone number.
Thank you. Rafael, read the next one.
Your laptop is black.
Thanks. Tony?
Our beer is nice.
Thank you. Say, our bird is noisy.
It's
Carmelina, noisy. It's okay. Carmelina, read the next one, please.
Hello. Their house is beautiful.
Okay, thanks. Their house is beautiful. Arnoldo, next one. Check your microphone, Arnoldo. Thanks.
My phone.
This one. That is.
That is our car.
Thank you.
Repeat.
Frank, can you read the next one, please?
Color is brown.
Thanks. Next one, Dalia Margarita.
They are my co-workers.
Thank you. Let's see, Susana.
Our class is in Turkey.
Okay, good. Abel, next one.
Your notebook is on the shirt.
Thanks. Let's see, who else? Zulma?
Sí.
Can you read the next example?
My classmates are nice.
Thank you. Lisette, you read the next one.
Her brother is handsome.
Thank you. There we have another one. Let's see. Rafael, read please.
Its name is Rocky.
Thanks. Then we have their pool is very big. And those are the examples we get. So as you see, we use the possessive adjectives in different ways, right? They can be in whatever place or whatever position in the sentence. And they go together with a noun all the time. Se pueden utilizar los pronombres, perdón, los adjetivos posesivos en distintas posiciones en la oración. Acá, por ejemplo, vemos my sister en la parte final, en el predicado. Then we have his pillow, que es parte del sujeto, her phone. Lo que sí es muy importante en cuanto a esto es que debemos siempre utilizarlo con un nombre. Por ejemplo, acá digo my sister. My sister, his pillow, si yo quitara el my, ya no estoy indicando la posesión, y si al contrario, quito el sister y me quedo solo con my, realmente no estoy diciendo nada lógico, no estoy completando mi idea, si le digo solamente this is my, este es mi, my what, right? So you always have to have the possessive adjective in a noun. We also have her phone number, your laptop, our bird. Here, what possessive do we have?
Their house.
Their
house. Their house. And here?
Our car.
Our car. This one?
Color.
It's color.
Color.
It's color. And in the next sentence we have
my
co-workers.
My co-workers. My co-workers. Next one.
Our class.
Our class. In the next sentence we got
your
notebook. Next one is
my classmates.
Here we have
her brother.
Next one is
its name.
And the last one,
their pool.
Entonces siempre vemos cómo formamos la frase, ¿verdad? Con un posesivo y un nombre. Our car, its color, my coworkers. Our class, and so on. So it's important to always have both of them, the possessive adjective and then a noun, the thing that we're talking about.
Excuse me, miss.
One question. Tell me. Okay, tell me.
En español. estaba viendo que en el primer ejemplo, this is my sister. Cuando se refiere a sister, está hablando de la hermana, diría ella. Y si lo ponemos this is, es como esto es, o no. O
sea, en ese
mi
caso,
punto es el por qué el this.
Ok. Sí, en ese caso no lo vamos a traducir como esto ni esta, ¿verdad? Sino que en español pues lo decimos diferente. Entonces sería ella es mi hermana. Pero en inglés sí tenemos permitido utilizar ese tipo de frase, this is my sister. También podríamos cambiarlo a she is my sister. Es otra de las formas que se pueden utilizar.
Puede ser válido.
Sí, exactamente. Así sería. This is my sister, this is my brother, this is my father, you can say. Okay.
Es que tenía esa duda. Recuerdo hace tiempo haber visto algo de esto y medio recuerdo lo del this.
Sí.
Entonces, pero como se refería a ella, entonces supuse que era she.
Sí, se puede decir, como le digo, de las dos formas, ¿verdad? Ahí depende de cómo usted quiera utilizarlo, pero esta estructura sí es válida en inglés. Yo sé que en español decir esta es, no, ¿verdad? No se puede. Pero en inglés, we can do it, like, this is my sister, this is my brother, this is my grandmother, and so on. Okay, so let me continue with the topic. Now, as you see, we have some different possessive adjectives for each of the pronouns. So let's remember the subject pronouns, I, you, What else? What are the subject pronouns?
He.
We got he. He. It.
She.
Oh my goodness, my internet doesn't want to work. Okay, so there we are. Let's write them again. So we got I, you,
we,
he,
she,
he,
it,
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 we,
they,
you,
they.
Okay.
They.
You and they.
They.
All right, so those are the subject pronouns. Now let's write the possessive adjectives. So for I, we got?
My.
My.
My. For you?
They.
Yours.
For you? Your.
Yours.
For he, we have?
His.
His.
She?
She's.
Her.
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 It?
Her.
It.
It. It's. We?
Our.
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 You?
Your.
Your. In they?
Their.
Their.
Okay, so those are the corresponding possessive adjectives. We got I, my, you, your, he, his, she, her, it, its, we, our, you, your, they, their. Now repeat after me. I, my.
I.
My.
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 You, your.
You.
You.
Your.
He, his.
He,
his.
She, her.
She,
her.
Her.
It, its.
It,
it,
is.
It, it.
We, our.
We,
our.
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 You, your.
You, your.
They, their.
They.
Okay, now let's make some examples. Help me with this, please. Make a sentence using my. Sentence using my.
My car is red.
My car is red. Okay, now one using your.
Your name is Jose.
Name is Jose. Okay, what else? Using his.
He's my father.
Oh, okay. Now that you mentioned that, let's remember that it's different, the possessive from the verb be, right? Both of them are pronounced the same way. His, his. But the structure is different. So remember, we use this for he is. He is my father. He is my brother. But his goes together with a name, right? Okay, so be careful with that.
His home is beautiful.
His home is beautiful. Very good. Okay, next one using here.
Her eyes.
Hair is pretty.
Hair what?
She's pretty.
Oh, okay. In that case, we should say she's pretty. She's pretty.
Hair.
We could say, for example, hair here is pretty. That will be different. Siempre hay que decir de qué estamos hablando. Por ejemplo, acá, hair, hair, su cabello. si solo lo utilizo como hair, realmente no estoy diciendo nada, ¿verdad? Hair, su what, right? So be careful with that. Okay, now its.
Its tail is long.
Its?
Tail.
Tail.
Cola, tail
uh-huh.
is long.
It's long. Good. Our?
Our country is beautiful.
Our country is beautiful. Your?
Your team is a champion.
Okay, great. In there. There, what?
Their kid is loud.
Their what? Can you repeat it?
Their kid is loud.
Their kid is loud. Okay. All right. So that is the way we use the possessives in sentences. So let me say it again. You use the possessive and then a noun. My car. Your name.
My car. Your name.
Your name.
His home. His home.
His home.
His home.
Hair, hair.
Hair,
hair.
Hair, hair. Hair.
Its tail.
Its tail.
Our country.
Our country.
Country.
Your team.
Your
team.
Their kids.
Their
kids.
Okay. Now I got some practice for you. Here, I have an exercise for you to solve it. So let me give you a couple of minutes so you copy it and complete it. You have to write a corresponding form of the possessive adjective. For example, in the first one, where is book? We got the subject I. So where is, what do we say?
My
book. Where is my book? Okay, complete the other ones, please. And then we're going to share them with the class. Do you have any questions?
Our?
In the second one, our. Okay, yes, complete them individually and then we solve the exercise all together, okay? Completa cada uno y luego compartimos.
Aquí como aquí.
Gracias. Okay, let's complete the exercise together. So we have number two. Here is
our teacher.
She goes to school with
her brother.
And father works in a car factory. Their father works in a car factory. Your laptop is very expensive.
Your.
And he favorite hobby is tennis.
His
favorite.
Yes, we say his favorite hobby is tennis. Number seven.
My husband
and I want to go to Paris. We want to see.
It's
historical monuments. Layla likes
hair dog.
Hair dog.
It name is Bobby. That's how it goes. We got my book, our teacher, her brother, their father, your laptop, his favorite hobby, my husband, its historical monuments, her dog, its name. Okay, do we have any questions about that? Is it clear? So then let's continue. We're going to skip this one because afterwards we're going to have more practice. So let me just tell you a little bit about the possessive nouns. Apart from the possessive adjectives, we also can make some possessive nouns. How come? Well, that is using the possessive S. And for that, we got some different rules. The first one says that in singular nouns, person, place, things, or idea, we add apostrophe and S after the noun. Here I have some examples. Rachel's car is in the garage. Rachel's car. Here we add an apostrophe S. We have Rachel, who's the owner of the car. Then we add apostrophe S, and then the thing that we're talking about, which is the car. Know that the possessive noun always comes before what the person or thing or a thing owns or has. Acá utilizamos en una forma invertida. Estamos hablando del carro, que el carro es de Rachel. Entonces, primero decimos de quién es, que en este caso sería Rachel, agregamos una apóstrofe, una S, y luego vamos a poner la cosa de la que estamos hablando, la posesión, que sería en este caso, the car, Rachel's car. Eso es en el caso de los nombres singulares, Rachel's car. My friend's name, I say. Okay, so now let me tell you about rule number two. In singular nouns ending with S, followed by a word starting with S, we just add an apostrophe to the noun. This is to avoid a hissing sound. Some examples. This school is in Malvilla Nagar. So here you see Texas. Texas is singular, but it ends in S. Para los nombres que terminan en S, como este, Texas, solo agregamos el apóstrofe. Ya no vamos a agregar la S porque entonces nos tocaría cambiar un poquito ahí la pronunciación y es un tanto difícil producirla. Es por eso que solo se deja el apóstrofe. We also have another example. Suha's sister is a teacher. Here, you only see the apostrophe. Nothing else. Or for example, if we would say Carlos' house. There, if you write it, it will be only Carlos, apostrophe, then house. People are copying. Let me give you some seconds. Okay, Then rule number three says that in plural nouns ending with S, we add apostrophe after S. For example, students' report cards are ready. Students. This is plural. And we only need to add an apostrophe. Students' report cards. Students' report cards. You need no S. Una vez más, estos terminan en S, solo se les agrega la, se les agrega el apóstrofe. No agregamos S, estamos hablando de un plural. Ya la tenemos acá, students. Then we have girls' dance classes have been postponed. Girls' dance classes. Girls, apóstrofe. Una vez más, la palabra girls es plural. Termina en S, entonces solo agregamos el apóstrofe. And our next rule says that in
tengo una duda, señor.
Tell me. Diga.
Creo que me he perdido un poquito. ¿Se le agrega el apóstrofe cuando el nombre va al principio de la oración?
No, el apóstrofe se agrega cuando estoy hablando del posesivo. Por ejemplo, acá lo que quiero decir es que las tarjetas reporte son de los estudiantes. Las tarjetas reporte de los estudiantes son, perdón, están listas, es lo que dice acá en esta oración. Las tarjetas reporte de los estudiantes están listas.
Sorry, entonces, teacher. Ajá. Creo que hay alguien con una interferencia, por eso es que casi no se entiende. Alguien está hablando algo más.
Ok, háganme el favor, por favor. Háganme el favor ahí con los micrófonos. Por favor, los apagamos. Gracias. Ok, voy a apagarlos yo acá y lo enciende nada más el que va participando. Entonces, Zulma, la idea del apóstrofe es ir indicando la posesión. Por ejemplo, acá, Rachel's car, el carro de Rachel. Es lo que es la idea del apóstrofe. No importa en qué lugar lo utilicemos o en qué posición la utilicemos en la oración. Lo importante es esta estructura. Es esto que estoy diciendo.
Cuando
que el
sea carro de es, posesión.
Exacto, estoy indicando que el carro es de Rachel, no estoy hablando de cualquier carro, sino que del carro de ella específicamente.
Ya, entonces sí, ya comprendí. Okay. Gracias, Miss.
You're welcome. Okay, so we're in rule number four. There we go. So in regular plural nouns, we add apostrophe and S to show possession. Para los plurales que son irregulares, como men, children, agregamos apóstrofe S. Por ejemplo, children's clothes are expensive. Children's clothes are expensive. Children's. La palabra children es plural. Sin embargo, como no termina con S, puedo agregar el apóstrofe y la S. Para indicar el posesivo. Then we have people's mindset needs to be changed. People's mindset. People's. People, una vez más, es plural. Pero como no termina en S, agregamos apóstrofe S. Okay, so here I have some practice for you. And we got color of the dog. So if I want to rewrite the phrase using the possessive S, how would it be? We say the dog's collar, right? The dog's collar. Acá lo que estoy indicando es el collar es del perro, right? Entonces, sí se puede utilizar esta estructura que acá les muestro como collar of the dog. De pronto la van a ver por ahí, pero no es lo usual, eso solo se utiliza en distintas situaciones, ¿qué les digo? Un poco más formales y son contaditas las veces que vamos a decir algo como eso, the friends of Aaron. We normally say Aaron's friends, Aaron's friends. Entonces, vamos a ir cambiando las frases de modo que vayamos utilizando la possessive S or the apostrophe. The second one, the friends of Aaron. Aaron. ¿Cómo cambiaríamos esa para utilizar la possessive S?
Aaron's friends.
We say Aaron's friends. Uh-huh. Next one, cookies of my grandmother. Any ideas? A ver.
Grandmother's cookie?
My grandmother's cookies. Okay, so let me tell you. Acá es importante identificar primero de quién es la cosa de la que estamos hablando. ¿Quién es el owner? El, how do you say, dueño. Por ejemplo, acá, egg of the bird. ¿Quién sería el owner? Who's the owner?
El pájaro.
El pájaro. Entonces eso es lo que voy a poner primero. The bird. Luego, como estoy hablando de un nombre singular, lo que necesito es agregarle el apóstrofe S, the birds, y luego digo de qué estoy hablando, cuál es la cosa que pertenece al bird.
Egg.
Egg. So I say the bird's egg. Number five, best friend of a girl.
The girls.
The girls.
The girls.
Friends.
Best friend. The girls' best friend. Okay, next one. Mom of David.
David's mom.
David's mom. Flowers of Jane.
Jane's flowers.
Chair of Tico.
Tico's chair.
Tico's
chair.
Chair. Work of Mauricio.
Mauricio's work.
Okay, cell phone of the teacher.
The teacher's cell phone.
Okay, so that's how it goes. Creo que ahora sí ya estamos agarrando la idea, ¿verdad? No sé si tienen consultas. Yes. Muy bien. Okay. ¿Sí, tenemos consultitas?
Y esta presentación no, la presentación que estaba utilizando, uno la podría enviar para tenerla como ejemplo, por si queremos practicar.
Claro que sí, yo se las puedo compartir. Se las voy a compartir entonces al final de la clase o mañana, en la mañana, ahí en el grupo de WhatsApp. Por ahí se las envío.
Thank you. Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome. So what we're going to do now is to keep on practicing, but in the small groups. Let's go to the breakout rooms. Let's have some time to practice with different exercises. So you're going to complete this one. We're missing from 11 to 20. So you complete that one. Then the other exercises I got for you. Then you have to make some sentences using the possessives from exercise 3. Algunos de los posesivos que tengamos de acá los convertimos en oración. Make a couple of sentences. Then you write the correct possessive adjective. Acá vamos a ir leyendo y vamos a ir poniendo el posesivo que corresponde. Then fill in the blanks using the correct possessive for the nouns in parentheses. Acá una vez más vamos a utilizar el possessive es. Sarah is Emily's aunt. These are our friend's cats. And so on. Ahí mismo vamos agregando el nombre y le ponemos el apóstrofe S o el apóstrofe según corresponda, dependiendo si es un nombre singular o plural. And then I want you to ask and answer those questions. What's your favorite color? My favorite color is. What's your favorite food? My favorite food is, and so on. Okay, so that is the practice. Let me send you to the breakout rooms now, and I'm sending you the pictures to the WhatsApp group. Okay. Right, there we go. Accept the invitation, please.
José Carlos Shoes.
Shoes.
Sí.
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 my cousin's clothes.
Y en la 15, ¿a dónde iría el apóstrofe?
Cousins.
Sería apóstrofe S.
Apóstrofe S, uh-huh. ¿Verdad? Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. Apóstrofe S. Sí.
Clothes.
Clothes. And leaves, the trees. Solamente que ahí sí. Creo que sería.
Es plural.
Plural. Entonces solo lleva uh-huh. Apóstrofe.
Solo el apóstrofe después de la S.
The trees. Leaves.
¿El apóstrofe es antes de la S o después de la S?
Después de la S.
Después.
Como este es plural, la palabra, entonces ya solo lleva la S, el apóstrofe al final.
Uh-huh.
Sí. En general, solo las palabras cuando terminan en S solamente les agregamos el apóstrofe.
Apóstrofe.
Toda palabra que termine en S solo agrégale el apóstrofe. Les explicaba las reglas para el singular y plural, pero en realidad es lo mismo. Siempre que termine en S, agrégale el apóstrofe.
The children.
Children's,
the children's toys.
Children's. The children's, the toys.
Toys.
Children's toys. Yes, your show.
The tree,
the
baby's bottle.
Bottle. Pero 19
Ali and Luis.
Enz and Luis.
Car.
Car. Oh, their car. Enz. And.
En ese caso, Luis. Como tenemos dos nombres, le vamos a agregar el posesivo al segundo nombre. So it will be Anne and Louis.
And the Louis.
Okay, what is it? Anne and Louis what?
Anne and Louis car.
Yeah, car. So you only add the apostrophe to Louis.
To Louis. Mm-hmm. Okay. Thanks.
Okay.
And 20.
Victoria's.
Out big.
Out Victoria's.
Mm-hmm. TV. San Victoria City. Ok, vamos con el 5. Ah, no.
Ese sería el que ya hicimos.
Make sentences using the possessive. Ah, que hagamos 5 oraciones usando las formas del cosito.
De posesión.
Mm-hmm. Make 5 sentences. Sería my
dog is beautiful.
My dog is beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, no, pero aquí no estamos.
Ah, sí.
No es lo de...
Ajá, es lo nombre, sino que con el... Ajá.
Sería... My brother's shoes.
Quiero ver...
My
sister is beautiful.
Cecilia, hello. Quiero ver, señor.
My house is big.
So it could be using the possessives that you were making in the last exercise. For example, in number 3, we got my grandmother's cookies. So you could say something like, my grandmother's cookies are delicious. Or our own friends are, what? Our own friends are talkative. Just take those phrases and make sentences. Okay?
Okay. Mm-hmm. Sería my...
En la 7 se podría utilizar la de... Donde dice... La flowers of gem. Podríamos usar el hair.
Uh-huh. Her flowers.
Ahí no, la idea no es que cambien de possessives a possessive adjectives, sino que utilicemos esas frases que ya hemos hecho con el possessive s, que las utilicemos en oraciones. Por ejemplo, Jane's flowers smell well. Las flores de Jane huelen bien.
Jane's flowers smell well. Y luego, sí sería otra opción decir her flowers smell well. En ese sentido, sí estamos comprendiendo, ¿verdad? Cómo va la concordancia con los adjetivos. Pero sí, mi idea es que utilicen las frases con el possessive S, ¿ok? So, try. Let's try to make one using the teacher's cell phone. Try to use that one in a sentence. Tratemos de hacer una oración con esa frase. The teacher's cell phone.
The cell phone of the teacher.
Mm-hmm. The teacher's cell phone. Completed. ¿Qué podemos decir del celular de la maestra?
The cell phone of the teacher.
The cell phone teacher is black?
The teacher's cell phone is black. Nada más que es lo que yo les explicaba, ¿verdad? Normalmente no decimos the cell phone of the teacher, decimos the teacher's cell phone.
Sí, sí, sí. Okay.
You say the teacher's cell phone is black.
The teacher.
Jane's flowers are red. Mr. Zamora's class is fun.
Podría ser Mauricio work is this easy.
Yes, that's a good example.
Cecilia's car is black.
Very good. Okay, I'm leaving, okay?
Okay,
see you in a moment.
Al nivel que siento yo que estamos ahorita, me siento como fuera de mi confort, ¿verdad?
Sí, lo que es, un amigo me dijo, tuvo la oportunidad de estudiar algo similar con Insafor, y al parecer ellos utilizan esta metodología como que para que uno se vaya adaptando al idioma, poco a poco conociéndolo.
Sí. Sí, sí, es buena estrategia, va.
Es correcto, entonces en teoría algunas frases o palabras que no conocemos son las que nosotros tendríamos que buscar. Yo al menos acá tengo el navegador, el traductor, perdón, a la par.
Ah, bueno, sí, ahí sí se ayuda, ¿verdad?
Correcto, no entiendo uno y otra, esta no la entiendo y chas, la busco. Entonces por eso preferí mejor hacerlo desde la compu.
Sí, hay más beneficios.
Yo ahorita voy llegando a trabajar, entonces no me quedo chance ni de encender la computadora, de hecho. Ya me estaba yendo.
Se le complica.
Sí.
Bueno, pero, entonces, ajá.
Volviendo a los ejercicios, yo creo que sí, se nos va a dificultar bastante esto sin la Miss. Porque sí. Al menos de mi parte, ¿qué? Yo soy sincero, yo aquí sí ando bastante extraviado, muy perdido.
Hello, I'm here. Por acá estoy, si me necesitan.
Sí, por favor.
Ok, sí, con gusto. Díganme qué les puedo ayudar.
Primero, estoy compartiendo pantalla porque el compañero no está agregado al grupo. Entonces no tiene las imágenes.
Ah, ok. Para agregarse al grupo, deben de buscar el link en...
Ya, o sea, ya me agregué al grupo.
Bueno.
Pero no tengo nada. El grupo está
como está
nuevo.
Recién integrado.
Ajá. Bueno, entonces, pero igual pueden ver aquí los ejercicios todos juntos.
Correcto.
Sí. Okay.
Ahora bien, el otro problema que considero que tenemos con los compañeros es de que andamos como un poquito perdidos.
Vaya, no se preocupen. Vamos a irlo haciendo juntos entonces. A ver, no sé si ya hicieron alguno de estos del ejercicio 3 que están compartiendo. ¿Ninguno?
No.
Vale.
No, ninguno.
Ok, entonces acá lo importante, les decía yo, es identificar quién es el dueño. ¿Verdad? Por ejemplo, en el primero, color of the dog. ¿Quién es el dueño?
El perro,
the dog. Uh-huh. Entonces vengo y digo the dog. The dog, y luego esa es una palabra singular. Entonces le agrego apóstrofe S, the dog's color.
The dog's collar.
Una consulta.
Dígame.
¿El apóstrofe S lo hace plural o...?
Lo hace posesivo.
Ah, ok.
Ajá, entonces acá lo que estoy diciendo, de hecho sería el mismo significado que tengo acá en estas frases. The collar of the dog, el collar del perro. Pero la diferencia reside en que normalmente yo no digo esto. O sea, cuando yo estoy hablando en inglés, no digo the collar of the dog, the friends of Aaron. Eso no se dice. Les decía yo, de repente van a encontrar alguna frase como esta, pero será en ocasiones bastante particulares. Normalmente utilizamos la otra forma con el possessive es. Entonces va a escuchar usted, por ejemplo, a un gringo hablando y va a decir... The dog's collar, Aaron's friends. Entonces, he puesto las frases así para que vayamos haciendo la relación, pero no debemos utilizarlas de esta forma, sino que con el possessive es. Entonces, si quieren, utilicemos el chat por acá para que vayamos escribiéndolas. We got the first one, the dog's collar. La segunda, the friends of Aaron, ¿cómo sería?
Ay, ya me perdí, ¿dónde vamos?
La número dos.
Sería,
the friends of Aaron.
Aaron's the friends?
Aaron's friends. Igual, como Aaron es singular, le agrego apóstrofe S. Aaron's friends. Siguiente, cookies of my grandmother.
My grandmother's.
My grandmother's. Cookies. Cookies. Number four.
Que le,
dígame.
Le quito OF, off.
Exacto, le quito la frase, la palabra, perdón, off. Y me quedo con lo demás. Entonces, estoy indicando el posesivo con la S, nada más.
Solo con el apóstrofe y la S.
Entonces, digamos que en español, si quisiéramos traducir esto, the dog's collar, el collar del perro. Lo hacemos como en forma invertida, ¿verdad? En español normalmente decimos primero la posesión, la cosa de la que estamos hablando, el collar del perro. Entonces, el perro que sería el dueño, ¿verdad? En inglés es al revés, the dog, que es el dueño, va primero. Luego indico el posesivo con el apóstrofe S o el apóstrofe nada más si fuese plural. Y después menciono la cosa de la que estoy hablando. No sé si me agarran ahí la idea.
Sí.
Al revés, ¿verdad? Ok.
Sí.
Digamos, number four.
Pero sí.
Ok, con la práctica vamos a ir mejorando, a ver. Egg of the bird.
The bird's egg.
The bird's egg. El huevo del pájaro. Then we have number five, best friend of a girl.
Girl's best friend.
Girl's best friend. Sería el mejor amigo o amiga de una chica o de una niña. Next one, mom of David.
David's mom.
David's mom. La mamá de David. Oh, I made a mistake. There you go. Number seven, flowers of Jane.
Jane's flowers.
Jane's flowers. Next one, chair of Tico.
Tico's chair.
Tico's chair. Work of Mauricio.
Mauricio's work.
Number 10, cell phone of the teacher.
The teacher's cell phone.
No, the teacher's cell phone.
Cell phone. OK. Okay, number 11, band of my boyfriend.
Boyfriend's band? My boyfriend's band?
My boyfriend's band. Class of Mr. Zamora?
Mr. Zamora's class.
Say Mr. Zamora's class. Pores of Luciana.
Luciana Pores.
Luciana's.
Luciana's purse. Shoes of Carlos.
Carlos shoes.
Carlos shoes. En ese caso, como Carlos termina en S, lo que vamos a hacer es agregar únicamente un apóstrofe. Porque aunque es plural, termina en S, ¿verdad? Entonces vamos a agregarle nada más el apóstrofe y eso sería lo que nos indica la posesión. Carlos shoes.
El
apóstrofe. ¿Diga? Ahí les
una pregunta, ¿el apóstrofe iría antes de la S?
No, si la palabra ya lleva S, como Carlos, que ya es el nombre terminado en S, le agrego el apóstrofe después de la S.
¿Cuándo es plural?
Ah, okay.
Cuando es, en el caso de Carlos, no es plural, perdón, pero no, si termina en S.
Es singular.
Ajá. Sí, es singular, pero aún así termina en S, entonces solo agrego la S. Eso sucede también con los plurales.
Solo para entender, si la palabra está en plural, como ya lleva la letra S, solo agregamos el apóstrofe. Si la palabra es singular, pero lleva una S, igual solo agregamos el apóstrofe.
Así es.
Ok.
Sí, justamente así. Por ejemplo, a ver, cambiemos... La de the teacher's cell phone. Ahí estoy hablando del celular de la teacher, ¿verdad? Si lo cambio al plural en esta forma, déjenme enviárselo, the teacher's cell phone. Lo cambio de esta forma, teachers. Le agrego únicamente el apóstrofe, porque ya no estoy hablando de un teacher, estoy hablando de varios en plural. En ese caso, solo le agrego el apóstrofe después de la S. Ok,
entonces, let's... Diga. ¿Dónde está la que he visto? Así como la de... La número 16. What is... Bueno, puedo escribirlo acá, ¿verdad?
Yes, go ahead.
Sería entonces
the trees.
Vamos a ver.
The trees. Leaves.
Leaves.
Trees, leaves. Leaves significa hojas.
¿Así?
Ajá. Leaves.
Trees, leaves.
Oops, no.
Ah, no, bueno, pero le cambió. Sí, porque es trees.
Perdón, ¿era acá?
Ok.
Ah, sí.
Con apóstrofe al final.
Ah, correcto. Aquí está.
Así es. Sí, entonces, digamos, en el primero que envió, que tiene apóstrofe S, estaríamos hablando de un solo árbol, las hojas del árbol. En el segundo, las hojas de los árboles.
Ok.
Esa sería la diferencia.
O sea que el error lo hice en singular y en plural.
Sí, así es. Así practicamos doble.
Ah, perfecto. Ok. Vale, esta parte sí, al menos yo puedo decir que sí ya la comprendí un poco. ¿Podemos copiarla o pasamos a la siguiente? Digo, porque si nos pregunta al regresar... Puede que de acá sí, sí voy a responder, porque de acá sí lo comprendí, pero de las otras.
Si quieren, chequeamos los demás ejercicios para que yo les pueda ir ayudando. Ahí, aunque ya pronto vamos a volver, pero veamos para que tengan una idea al menos.
Ok, ¿esa es la siguiente?
Ah, ok. Ahí les pedía que hiciéramos oraciones utilizando las frases del ejercicio anterior. Por ejemplo, la última que acaban de enviar, the tree's leaves. The tree's leaves are green. The tree's leaves are green. Ahí estoy haciendo una oración. Déjenme enviársela. The tree's leaves are green. Ahí, al principio teníamos solo la frase, the tree's leaves. Ahora ya le hicimos oración, ¿verdad? Las hojas de los árboles son verdes. The tree's leaves are green.
One question.
Tell me.
En la anterior teníamos agregado the trees. Pero solo agregamos el tree's leaves. Y en esta ocasión sí agregamos the trees.
Sí, ahí realmente depende de la oración. Por ejemplo, acá estoy diciendo las hojas de los árboles. Es por eso que digo the trees. Los. Okay. Ese the significa el, la, los o las. Entonces ahí estoy diciendo los árboles. Por eso es que lo necesito, ¿verdad?
Correcto.
Okay, we could also make another sentence like the teacher's cell phone is white. Carlos' shoes are new. Luciana's purse is big. De esa forma las podemos ir utilizando en oraciones.
¿Preguntas, compañero? Aprovecho.
No, no, sí, sí, he comprendido. Me preocupa que no vamos a terminar.
No, no se preocupen, no se preocupen. Igual lo mejor es que comprendamos. Entonces, siempre y cuando vayamos entendiendo lo que estamos haciendo, pues ya es ganancia. Así que tranquilos, igual vamos a seguir siempre con los reviews que hacemos al inicio para que vayamos recordando lo de la clase anterior y todo eso, así que no se preocupen, vamos a seguir practicando.
Okay. Ah, bueno, está bien, gracias.
Next exercise.
Next.
Exercise
2. Okay. Exercise 2. Ahí tenemos que utilizar los possessive adjectives. Ahí vamos a utilizar my, your, his, her, our, their. And it's. So we have, for example, number one, that is my sister's husband. My sister's husband. El esposo de mi hermana. Entonces digo, that is my, your. Pero es el esposo de mi hermana. Entonces es ella.
Ah, her.
Her. That is her husband. Sí, esa es otra cosa importante. No importa la palabra que vaya después, sino que lo que tomamos como referencia es, digamos así, el dueño o la dueña de lo que estamos hablando, ¿verdad?
Entonces ahí...
En este caso estamos hablando del
esposo. Estamos hablando del esposo de mi hermana.
Él es su esposo, diría.
Él es su esposo, exactamente. Mm.
Sí.
Number two, this shirt belongs to me. This is belongs to me.
What is belong?
Me pertenece.
My
shirt. This is my shirt. Number three, that is Frank's sister. That is
hablando
de la hermana de Frank.
Ajá, his
sister. Siguiente. This is Martha's brother's pillow.
Yes, también, ¿no?
This is his pillow.
Yes.
Así es. This is his pillow. la del hermano, ¿verdad? Estamos hablando de que la almohada es del hermano. Next one, that is our neighbor's plant. That is
our.
Estoy diciendo que es our neighbors, de nuestros vecinos. La planta de nuestros vecinos.
There.
There. That is their plant. This house does not belong to us. This isn't. Esta casa no nos pertenece. Esta casa no es.
It.
No, we're talking about us.
No.
Estoy diciendo que esta casa no es de nosotros.
No.
¿Cómo sería?
They.
Our. No, it's our.
Our. Exactly. This isn't our house. Isn't our house.
Our house.
Next one, you live on this street. This is? This is, you live on this street.
In Spanish.
Tú vives en esta calle o sobre esta calle.
Two is yours.
Yours.
Your. This is your street. David and his brother live on that street. That is?
Their.
Their street. Next one, this comb belongs to my Aunt Selma.
Her.
This is her comb. Number 10, those glasses belong to my brother's friends. My brother's friend's aunt's daughter. Oh, that's a long one. Those are?
His.
His. His glasses. Okay, ¿estamos claros con ese?
Sí, sí. Sí, Miss, muchas gracias.
Muy bien.
Sí, creo que sí.
Okay, good.
Finisher or net? Next exercise.
Okay. Voy a retirarme porque necesito chequear con los demás grupos cómo van. Si quieren, intenten y si no, pues igual luego vamos a clarificar un poquito ahí las dudas. Y como les digo, no se preocupen, vamos a seguir practicando esto.
Ok.
Gracias, Miss.
Ok, thank you, you're welcome.
Thank you.
Okay. Es bien difícil.
Sí.
Ah, pero con esfuerzo salimos adelante.
Sí, primero.
Sí.
Exacto. Bueno, muy bien.
Terminamos bien rápido ahora.
Sí, hombre, sí, ahorita ni hayamos que hacer, wow.
Did you finish?
No, pero nos estamos conociendo.
Yes, we did, yes. Teacher.
Oh, great. So how was the practice? ¿Cómo sintieron la práctica? How was it?
Ah, pues,
very, very well.
Piece of case.
It was okay. All right. Muy bien. No les costó.
Ready for the exam.
Perfect. Okay, good. So then mañana tenemos examen. And then.
Ya nos asustó, ya nos amargó el día también que dice.
No, come on. I don't want to be a bad teacher. No. Okay, so we're coming back in just a minute.
Okay, thanks.
Okay.
See you in a moment.
Cousins.
Cousins.
Hi there.
Hi.
Hi, hi.
How are you doing? ¿Cómo van?
Quemando la cabeza.
Okay.
Running tonight.
Okay, so do you have any questions?
I have a question.
Okay, tell me.
In the exercise two, in the en la en número 10, no.
Exercise 2, number 10. Let me see it.
Those glasses belong to my brother, friends, and daughter.
Oh, yeah, that's a long
one. No duda.
Sí, a ver, tratemos de traducirlo para comprenderlo mejor, si gustan. Sería la hija de la tía del amigo de mi hermano. La hija de la tía del amigo de mi hermano. Entonces,
la
hija. Sí, van, como recordemos que lo decimos como en orden invertido, ¿verdad? Ajá. Entonces ahí voy leyendo de atrás para adelante, por así decirlo. The daughter, la hija, aunts, de la tía, friends, del amigo o amiga, brothers, de mi hermano. Entonces sería la hija de la tía, del amigo, de mi hermano. Por tanto, tenemos those are. Al final, la dueña de los, what are those glasses? La dueña de los glasses es la daughter. Entonces, ¿cómo sería?
Those are daughters.
Those are our glasses.
Those are glasses. Hair glasses. Hair glasses. Hair. Ahí en ese ejercicio, no sé, porque ya no me fijé, la verdad, que no tenía la indicación, disculpen. Ahí teníamos que utilizar los possessive adjectives. My, your, his, her, our, and their. No sé si lo estamos haciendo así.
Number four,
let me check it.
Martha's brother's pillow.
Martha's brother's pillow, exactly. La almohada del hermano de Martha. So this is, what do we say? His hair, his pillow. That's how it goes. Así sería.
This is pillow.
Está hablando.
Y no lleva apóstrofe, ¿verdad, dicho?
Con los adjectives no utilizamos apóstrofe. My, your, his, todos esos no llevan apóstrofe, solamente el adjective y el nombre. O la cosa de la que estoy hablando.
Okay.
So we're coming back to the main room. Vamos a volver a la clase en este momento. Right, see you later. Oh, hello, everyone. How was the practice? What can you tell me?
It was okay.
Easy. It was okay? All right. Were you able to finish?
Yes.
Yes?
Yes.
Very good.
Yes.
So, do we have any questions about it? No? Okay. No. All right, good. So let's continue by doing a little practice on our manuals. So we're going to work on this, page number 15. Oh no, 16, sorry. So it's page number 16 on our manuals. It's how to use possessive adjectives in nouns. And first of all, we got the possessive adjectives in the table. I, my, you, yours, he, what is the possessive for he?
They.
Okay, and then we got some possessive nouns. Our teacher's name, you see the apostrophe S. We also have Pedro's address. And again, you have apostrophe S. Melissa and Dora's last name. So you see in the case when you have two different nouns, you add the possessive to the last one. Cuando tenemos dos nombres, como el caso de Melissa and Dora, le agregamos el posesivo al último. Al último nombre. Okay, so here we are going to ask a partner to spell the information and write it on the spaces. So we have to spell our teacher's name, our classmate's name, our classmate's occupation, and a classmate's last name. So let me ask some of you to participate. Let's see. Cecilia, can you spell your teacher's name, please? Check your microphone.
Thanks. Your name?
Yes, your teacher's name.
Is L? L E? No, L I?
F?
L E? A M A.
Okay. All right. So Liliana, L I L I A N A. Right? Liliana, L I L I A N A.
A N A.
Very good. Now let me see. Abel, can you spell Alfonso's name? So you spell Alfonso.
Alfonso. One moment.
Okay, spell it.
A L F O N S O.
Perfect. Now, Tony, you spell Susana.
S S U S 8 N 8.
Okay, and we say S U S A N A. Very good. Susana, can you spell Ronald?
R O N A L.
D, it takes a D. Okay, good. Now Ronald, spell Lisette.
No lo puedo deletrear.
Try. I mean, Lisette, just try. Yes. I may help you. So let me grade it over here so we can see it. So it goes like Lisette. It's L
I
I S S
E
E
D
T H. All right, so we say L-I-S-S-E-T-T-E. That's for Lisette. Now Lisette. Lisette, can you spell Arnoldo?
Okay. A R N O L D O.
Very good. Arnoldo, spell Rafael.
Rafael. R A F A E L.
Okay, good. Now, next one, number three, a classmate's occupation. So let me see, Carmelina, what's your occupation? Can you spell it?
Okay. T.
What else?
T E A.
Oh, what's your occupation? Yes, now we can hear. You're a teacher, so let's spell it one more time. So it goes T
E
E
A
A
R R
and C.
I pardon. C H
H
E
E
R.
R, right? Teacher. Very good. Thank you, Carmelina. Now let me see, Frank. What's your occupation?
Occupation is artist.
Artist. How do you spell that?
A R C I S T.
Very good. Lisette, what's your occupation?
Account. A C C U M T.
Okay, let's do it one more time. Accountant. Spell it.
Okay. A C C O U M T A M T.
Very good. Thanks, Lisette. Arnoldo, what's yours? What's your occupation?
I M F R A E S T R U C D O R A.
Okay, what's your occupation again? Can you say it?
What?
Can you say what's your occupation? What's your occupation? Tell me.
Vuelvo a repetir lo mismo.
No, dígame a qué se dedica. Just the word.
Es infraestructura.
Oh, infrastructure. That's why it's a long word. Okay. All right, good. Now let me ask for the last names. Number four, a classmate last name. Let's see. Carlos, can you spell Grijalva?
Grijalva. Es E R I A A L B A.
Okay, Grijalva, right?
Sure.
Yes, just I don't know if it was me, but I didn't hear the J. I don't know if you mentioned it. So it was I-J-A. Thank you, Carlos. And let me get another one from Tony. Tony, can you spell? Let me see whose last name.
Sorry.
Rodriguez.
My last?
No, Rodriguez. Spell Rodriguez.
Uh-huh. Spell Rodriguez, okay. One moment.
Sure.
Sería solo... Lo voy a copiar porque si no me pierdo.
Oh, I can spell it to here. I can, great.
Mm-hmm. Sería...
R.
O. O. D. R. A. G. U.
U. Z. Okay, Z. Just over here. This one is I. I. So it's R O D R I G U E Z. Okay, so we're going to continue practicing these topics tomorrow. So don't worry about them. We're going to continue practicing. Also, I'm going to send you the presentation so you have it and you can check the exercises that we have been doing and the information that I have given to you. And that will be all for today's class. So thanks everybody for participating. Take care. Have a good night.
Good night.
Bye. Bye. Good night.
Good night. Bye.
Bye.
Thank you, miss.
You're welcome.
Good night.
Bye. Thanks.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.